This is itty bitty baby buddy boy. Itty bitty baby buddy boy. And he's been living in this dish for 3 days. And today I took Bubbles out of the bathtub and put her into the pond, and she's adjusting extremely well. So I decided to reset the bathtub for itty bitty baby buddy. And so now she's going to move right before our very eyes. I'll try to hold the camera still while I do this. I'll put it on my leg here. Okay, itty bitty baby buddy. Come with me. Come with me, itty bitty baby buddy. Come with me. And put you on the brick and see what you do. When you went right in the water. Why am I surprised? That's what you usually do. Okay, we'll get this dish out of here now. I put this rock so he can get up on that rock and then get up on this brick. And then he can get up on this brick. And then he can get up on this brick. And of course, you can see there's a light in there. So he's checking out his new digs. When I put Bubbles in the pond, I put her in right on the rocks at the water's edge. And she went in the water and went down to the bottom and came back up. Almost acted like a cat. You know, when you put them in the kitty litter and they go out and explore a little bit and they come back to the kitty litter pan. Well, that's what Bubbles did. She did that about 3 times, and I was so excited. I mean, the pond is 5 and 6 feet deep, and I was concerned about her coming back up, but she came back up, and one of the fish at the bottom, when she was at the bottom, one of the fish came up and looked at her, and they were face to face, and Bubbles tuckered her head in, and then the fish swam away. And then a little while later, three of the other painted turtles came up to visit Bubbles. Bubbles is a painted turtle, and this is a painted turtle. So she had a welcoming committee, and then they all went away, and then Bubbles took another dive at the bottom of the pond, and then I went about my business and came back, and here she'd come up again. And and when I had her in the bathtub, she'd come and sit in my hand. So when I put her in the pond, I kept talking to her the whole time. I must have talked to her for a half hour, singing her my little song, Tiny Bubbles in My Tub. And so I put my hand down there when she came back up, and she went right in my hand. So that was a beautiful launching. Well, this is going to be an absolutely boring video, itty bitty baby buddy. You're going to wear yourself out swimming. And then you're going to fall asleep and float around. That's the deal. So I'll back off so you can see the whole setup here. I didn't clean the algae off the bricks because I figure if she accepted food the second day, I couldn't believe it, but she hasn't taken any food since then. I mean, he hasn't taken any food since then. So he can always nibble on the algae if he wants to. He hasn't done that much. Well, he did do quite a bit of swimming in his little dish. But this is Maud's baby, and Maud was one on the welcoming committee today. He had a brother, and the brother didn't make it. He wasn't too healthy. And Maud laid her eggs in the fall, and I wasn't exactly sure where. If I knew where they were, I would have dug them up and incubated them. But so they stayed underground all winter, and then found their way out of the ground. And I found this one on the patio. I could have just as easily stepped on him. I turned to walk away, and I just happened to look down, and there he is, and he just blends right in with the, you know, natural color on the patio. So, okay, itty bitty baby buddy boy. We'll check in with you later. Enjoy your new home. You cute little thing, you. Okay, over and out.